I may look a little different from the others, but my religion teaches me to dress like that, have a turban and hair and all that. My religion is the youngest religion of the world. It is only 500 years old. And our first guru was born in 1469 and he died in 1539. And he was a very vibrant, very intelligent boy when he was born. He learned a lot of, from the Maulvis, from the Pandits, from everywhere. But he was mostly working in the fields, taking care of his cows and buffaloes. At the age of 16, his father gave him 20 rupees and told him to go and forget about this trade. You go and buy something and make some business, because his father was a patwari or a revenue master in his own village. So he went with one of his friends to buy some material for business, and he bought some things. But while going, say about 25 miles from his place to buy the stuff for business, he saw few fakirs, few persons just very hungry and sitting in the forest and waiting if somebody can come and feed them. Baba Nanak, our first guru, when he was coming back, he said, you did not eat anything? And they said, no, we did not. He said, so I have brought this stuff, he cooked it with his friends and feed all those rishis, munis, beggars, everybody who happened to be there at that very time in the forest. And he fed them. He was very happy in himself, but he was very scared of his father. He said, when I will go home, I have no money, and I have spent the whole money in buying this stuff, and I have fed these beggars and everybody, those who needs some food or some clothes or something. He helped everybody. When he went home, and he sat outside the village, he didn't go in the village. When his father came to know, he came, he was very mad. He said, oh, you just wasted the money. He said, no, Dad, this is the best way to invest the money. Those people were poor, I fed them. His father was real mad, and the Rai Balar, the Muslim head of that village, was very mad on his father. He said, he is a noble soul. Why you are just beating him and getting mad on him? He did the right thing. So the first, say about 18 years, he lived with his father. Then he went for a job in, say about 40 miles from his house. And he served over there as a Modikhana, the in charge of the Modikhana, or the over the food and grains, and he was working over there. And after 12 years working over there, the people got mad sometime. They said, what is this man? Time is over?
5 minutes.
Okay. What this man is doing over here? They complained to the king of that place, and he got mad, but everything was accounted, and he came to know that everything was all right. He got mad. He made up his mind. He started traveling the world. He traveled 22 years of his life. He went in the Assam, in the south, in the north, and then into Mecca and Medina. He went over there, and he was preaching always to the people to serve the poor, help those people. And he was very successful. And the first His first stop was at one place in Ahmedabad, where he went to a very, very poor man's house. He stayed with him. The in charge of that village was mad on him. He said he comes from such a good family and living with such a low caste person. Then he told him, I can feed at you, but all the food you will serve me. He brought the food, he took his food in his right hand, where he was staying in his left hand, and he showed him that the food he was having with the low caste person is all milk and the other is all blood. So the other person came to know that I am not doing the right thing. So when he died, one of my friends here, Mr. Patti, he went over there, his place is where he died in Kartarpur, it is in Pakistan. He went over there. The Muslims were very unhappy with the Hindus. They said, he is our guru. And do you said our guru? The Muslim created a mosque over there, and the Sikhs created a Gurdwara over there. We have been guided by him, how to help the poor, how to feed the poor. And if you go to see our Gurdwara or our temples, it has always four doors. Anybody can come from any door to that temple. We do not believe in conversion and all that. But everybody, even on Sunday, we have a big Gurdwara in Palatine. You can come. Anybody can come at any time, will be served food over there. You have to sit on the ground, whether you are a prince or a pauper. But you all have to sit together on the ground, eat together the same food in our temple. And wherever you will see our temple, it has four doors. Everybody is welcome. We do not believe in conversion. We only believe if you want to join us, come and sit over there, eat, and listen to the beautiful hymns from our Bani. And I am being told about my time, but I must say and congratulate the people who have took this subject for today's discussion, that the need of the poor people or the ordinary people. And I must congratulate you people who have chosen this subject. And then at the same time, I must tell you, I have read Quran Sharif 3-4 times. I have read at least 10 books on the life of Muhammad Sahib, peace be on him. And in the Quran Sharif, even I have read, in the whole of the Quran Sharif, I have read there is no word taking. There is only one word, giving, giving, and giving. So I have read the Bible. So I have read all these religious books, and I came to the conclusion that all these people, all these religion, tell the others to just feed the needy, and help everybody. That's all.
Good evening. It's a pleasure to be with all of you here tonight.